How's it going, everyone? Back with another stream today. We're playing some more modern black green rock. I've been really liking this deck. I've been really liking the changes that I made so far to the list. Having 8 fetch lands, so you know, 2 marsh flats, 2 windswept teeth, keeping up with abs and theme, along with of course the 4 verdant catacombs, the main deck haywire mite, and the main deck 1 of tireless tracker. I think those changes feel really, really good. The only change that I'm really making compared to the last video I did for playing Black Green Rock was I felt like I was really naked against Burn. And I feel like it's coming to the point where I can't really ignore the deck. So I just have 1 Collective Brutality. I replaced the Bojuka Bog for 1 Collective Brutality. I feel like Bojuka Bog is like completely contingent on Reclaimer being active for us to, you know, be able to essentially instant speed it. So I think Brutality is just going to be a little bit better to hedge against Burn specifically. If we really want to hedge against Burn, it could be a lot of other things, but I think Brutality is probably a little bit more versatile compared to, you know, something like what's like the green storm, like gain 2 life, or you know, just any of just like the just the strictly like gain life spells. I think Brutality is just more versatile. So other than that, like the rest of the deck is unchanged. So let's get on with it. Feed the Clan, I think, is the, it just came to my head. I think it's Feed the Clan. Speed the Clan, right? Oh, that's the one with Ferocious, I think, actually. Yeah, Feed the Clan is the one where you gain 5 and then you gain 10 if you control like a literally a Tarmogoyf or something. What's the storm? Weather the Storm. If you really, really want to target Burn, I guess we could do Weather the Storm. This is kind of an interesting hand. I wonder when I should crack the bauble. We're on the play, so that's nice. Play Reclaimer and pass. Oh my. I wonder if I should play the Goyf out or if I should play the drum. Doesn't matter, they can upkeep top it and I can't make mana anyway. So I might as well play Goyf and pass. They like give this island walk, that sucks. Or turn this into an island with whatever their other Merfolk spell is. Interesting. This Reclaimer kind of doesn't really matter. I guess I should have double blocked. I guess it wouldn't have mattered. Okay. That's just me being unfamiliar. I think I'll keep this bauble uncracked. I think we're just gonna lean on Saga winning the game. Yeah. Forgot about the Hexcatcher. Land out the top would be good. This is where like Shadow Spear is going to come in clutch. Land. Oh, sure. I think you just race, right? They could go double lord, attack 4, 3, 5, 7. Like, that's fine. Attack for 3. Think this is a spot where I'll probably crack. Faloon. So I won't make a construct. I think it's better off just to play the Tarmogoyf here. I'll get a Haywire Mite as a way to. Make mana, equip this attack, play backup Tarmogoyf. Yeah. How's it going, Sandy? How are we doing, buddy? They want to trade both these creatures for Goyf. I think that's fine. This also bluffs Fatal Push very well, too. Haywire Mite pulling weight here. Is this. Then we have Lethal. The hand is Master of the Pearl Trident, Svealoon. Oh, damn, dude, that always happens to me too. I always miss cash. It's just like a thing. So I can't attack. Five, nine, 11, 16, 19. So they need to draw, not draw a Spreading Seas for an Island Walker. You can also just draw an instant, and then this will outgrow Svealoon. Not drawing Fatal Push or Bloodthirsty Slurs kind of sucks. Oh my god, they drew the Tideshaper. Five, nine, 13, 18. Is that Xaxes? That is Xaxes. Holy cow. It's lethal, right? Five. 5, 9, 13, 18, 21. Yeah. Everything has ward. They should just went for it. Interesting. Be a removal spell. Well, that's a pickle. So go to 15, crack a clue. I could sacrifice my Haywire Mite. I go up to 21. Suicide my Tarmogoyf into a Swaloon. But then they go 5, 9, 13, 18, 21, 25. Yeah, but like we're still dead on the craft pack, right? We thought sees. Like we technically lose two, but gain potentially six, maybe seven back if they have like a dismember or something. But then they attack back for 25. Like I literally needed to draw a removal spell there to kill this. But it has ward and everything too, so. No, they have the Swaloon that. I mean, they just take it though. Like that's just not gonna happen. Oh, that's true. I guess I could take away Indestructible, huh? That is a good point. The hidden mode of Shadow Spear. But then I don't think they block, though. I think they just take it. I guess I could have attacked to force it, but, like, tried to hope they make a mistake. I guess I should have done that, but. Yeah, we'll trim one of those. I guess I was. I should have hoped that they make the mistake. I guess that is true. But there's no way they're blocking. I'll leave him with the 7th edition one because that one looks cool. So, Woodland came in the vial. Probably a mill. High roll of land, I think. Work seems good. They spreading seeds my forest, I'm gonna be sad, but they're not spreading seeds my saga, so. Hand is dismember unknown. I might just push this now. There's an argument to not play the saga now and just like play with or work than tracker, but excuse me. They have the dismember. So I think I play the tracker here to bait the dismember. The Urborg. Next turn we can make a construct play Tarmogoyf. I'm assuming they'll dismember here. Okay. Thoughtsy. Oh, I should have played the land first. I'm so dumb. I'm not thinking through these plays. Could have got another clue out of this. I am not smart. It's annoying. I didn't even float the man either. Because it doesn't matter. It does not matter. I guess I could have got another clue, so it would have mattered that way. I'm playing really bad. So we need to fade another Merfolk so then their Svealoon doesn't get indestructible. It's annoying. I should have another clue. Where's the last card? Okay.
Hmm.
Damn. It's brutal. Brutal. If I had the other clue, I would have made a construct on block too. So it could have been a 4-4. So they would force at least one of the tricksters. Man, this is just cascading mistakes too. Getting super punished for like missing this minor thing. We don't have. I think I attack here. At least we have force lethal next turn. If they have Lord plus Island Walk, so be it. Still in actually an okay spot because we can equip the Shadow Spear onto a construct and attack. There's our last card. If we have anything, we're dead. I think we just go for it, right? Block, block. That's 1, 2, 3. So 4, Champlore. So we have to attack with this Reclaimer. 7, 3, 4. Yeah, so they can. If we just attack with these two, then they chump and they go to 1. So I think we just go for it. If they have anything, we're gonna die anyway, so. The mistake I made definitely cost me, I think. Darn. In game one, I just played horribly. I should have just taken the 1. I guess it would have been 2, but then we would have a Reclaimer. These mistakes are just, like, costing me. I think this is what happens when I'm just going back and forth between Pioneer and Modern, is I can just get rusty with both. And I think that's the issue. It's just, like, I just forgot about the Flash Lord. Like, I should just know to play around the Flash Lord. That just seems like a very obvious thing to do. I think we could have won both games. Our opponent definitely drew pretty well the second game. And I feel like we're in a position to do well that second game too, but I think it's just unfortunate that we it's Prowess. I think I'll bobble myself. Besage you. I guess maybe I should have saved the bobble. Because like I want a Thought Seize anyway. Now I kind of have to like fetch shock. Go to 15 against the Prowess deck. Our hand is like not good against it too. I Hopefully their hand is just bad, and then we draw like Fatal Push, Lava Dart. So I think we'll take the Soul Scar Mage, and then hope to draw Green Source. Can't play this lava, this Bob because of this Lava Dart, so they drew a Soul Scar Mage. That's pretty good. They could mutagenic growth it though. Is it worth it to trade the Withering Command for a growth? I think so. Sucks. I think it's worth it though. I mean, we're just not drawing any rule spells, and this Withering Command doesn't really count, unfortunately. Mill over drum, I don't know if that'll matter. Oh, they hit the blue source. See, looking good. They have sorcery, instant creature. Yeah, the problem with endurance is they can just dart it. Which they might not do, but... Lava Dart's just, like, so good against our... The fact that they drew their second Soul Scar Mage is what really sucks. Because it's shrinking our endurance is just so bad for us. I'm just gonna doing this now. Wow. So I go to 3. I need to draw a Fatal Push here. Because then I can push this Shadow Spirit equip attack. Gain 3 in theory. Or 4 even. Even a Reclaimer would be fine. Reclaimer, we got the Reclaimer, for sure. I think we have to... play Shadow Spear. Up here. Go to 5. I should have played the Fetch Land. This is a huge mistake. I am not thinking through these plays. Because I could have played the fetch, and then this would be a 3-4. Yeah, super punished. It's super punished. Okay, go rewarded. Might have been better just to like make a construct and crop rotate with the reclaimer. It's tough to say. Sure. Nope, I think we're in a pretty good spot now. Yeah. But we got lucky they didn't draw their lands either. that was definitely lucky for us for sure. Brutality. This is where brutality looks pretty okay. Would I rather have Bob or Thoughtseize? I think I'd rather have Turak than all the above. So maybe one Thoughtseize. True enough lands, yeah. I think we want this over Thoughtseize. Sucks that Withering Claim doesn't really kill much. It doesn't kill any of their prowess threats. I like how they just mismatch these. No, let's try that. No black mana. All right, we need another mana source. Please don't be a monkey. Please don't be a monkey. Please don't be a monkey. Soul Scum Rage. Deal. That's pretty good. Lava Dart, light up the stage. My time zone sucks for you. I'm sorry. So we can take this Lutz and then hope that their Soul Scrimmage kind of sucks. I think that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to take their Lutz. Because they're like starving on lands again, so I think that's the plan. God, they're Thoughtseizing bug us like all the time. Oh my god, that's so crazy. So crazy. Oops, they still have a Soul Scar Rage in hand. I just unchecked it. So I'll take their other Soul Scar Mage. Do I play the Saga? I can just dart it. I think I just play this Reclaimer. Hope it could be a speed bump. And then just draw and explosives, I think. That Lutz off the top was just so good for them. There's an argument to, like, take the Mana Morphos here, but, like, like, without an Engineering Explosive, we'll kill three creatures. Like, they were kind of fucked. We kind of hope that they spend the dart, and then if we draw, like, a Tarmogoyf or something, they're in a decent spot. endurance. They don't have a burn spell. We can try to endurance them. Oh. Two, three. Oh, man. This growth will save everything. Gosh, darn it. And this Wither Wound Command is like such a liability of Prowess being tier one. Wow, they ping that. How do we win this game? Go to six. If we draw a removal spell, we can push this. Prop rotate. So if we kill double Wyvern Commander Soul Scar Mage, we can go to 10. We could also just try to high roll and hit two lands. Make this Reclaimer into a 2-3. But I feel like we're just gonna chump anyway. Do we just like drain, double drain two? How do we get out of this? What is this cursed burst date? I don't know. They should have attacked. Push. Fatal push. Fatal push. Wait, they bolted? Why didn't they just bolt me? I would be dead. Yeah, the trolling is definitely the good way to put it. Let's get a mana source here. Push. think we'll just run this back. Run this back. So if Prowess is more popular than like regular burn, I don't like Collective Brutality in the sideboard. Just because of the fact that like it's not like we need our removal spells to be removal spells, and Mulligan is six. If they play Turbo Ragavan and I can't cast this with Living Command, I'm gonna be not very happy. Okay, I think I'm gonna play around Blood Moon though. I think I'm gonna get basic forest. I feel like we're in the position where we kind of can. I was debating if I should like not run the Rot Farms, and this is a situation where like I kind of think it's correct. See. Source Command, sure. I wish I could like just go triple reclaimer. It would be so much better. This Rot Farm is just like good and bad. We do have a third mana source, but like at the same time it's just like we're not able to deploy. Like I would like to double spell. Okay, that means they don't have a free spell in hand, which is good for us. That being said, like, now this is the kind of advantage of the crew where, like, now we have three mana sources instead of just two. Give and take, right? Okay. The sacking a crew also count for plus two cards in the graveyard. I wish. I wish. Oh my god, that's so good. Golly. I don't think I get Saga here. Yeah, I think I get a fetch land. If they have an instant, they can save this Darcy, which is really annoying. I think I'm gonna try to debate him. Quad Reclaimer is quite the clock, yeah. they doing here? Oh my god. Wow. This is actually pretty absurd. So, this bolt is targeting this reclaimer. So... There's an argument to, like, just kill this one. We can kill this one. So if I go for the throat, the Swiss spear, we're left with two reclaimers. If I go for the throat, the Soul Scar Mage, we're left with one reclaimer. But then they're left with a Soul Scar Mage. It's kind of a tough call. Bolt here. So if we kill this, yeah. I think I take the card advantage. Something to think about, though. Something to think about. One, two, three, four, five. I could Shadow Spear, equip Reclaimer, attack, and then hold up a Reclaimer activation. I think that sounds good to me. While they sacrifice the overgrown tomb. Okay. It's pretty good. Am I still playing around Blood Moon? I think I am. I think I sacrificed the Overgrown Tomb. I guess I'll just take this. It's like, once we get the first saga going, it's like, it's kind of diminishing in returns, right? We play Reclaimer, hold up saga activation. And we don't have that mana to activate another time. They bolt me, we take 6, go to 8. I think we take this. Oh my god. not play around the LUTs. Okay, well, the good news is they tapped out. That's good for us. Am I going to be activating Reclaimer? So I can make a construct. 1, 2. Sack. Make a construct. So yeah, I guess I could get another Saga and Overload. Pay land already. I could also just like activate Saga and then just like. Oh, they enter. We'll block here, I think. Saga take over the game. Oh, Fatal Push is a good draw. Push this. See if we get spell pierced. Aldereth 33. Thank you for the follow. Appreciate it. They do have the bolt. I guess I should have pushed this and then Withering Command this, but I think that's fine. So here at this point, I think I just make a construct. So attack with the Reclaimer. So I just play other Reclaimer and pass? I guess so, huh? We're at 18. Pretty safe light total. I should have activated my, used my mana better. I could hold that spell bomb. Okay, that's the card they drew. Okay. Interesting. Targeting me. I will exile the graveyard. Exile the graveyard. Cool. That spellbomb tutor was pretty clutch, huh? Reclaimers, baby. Reclaimers. Big D. Man, this hand is like loaded, but on the draw, I might have kept that hand. Thought season to push West Reclaimer is pretty good though. And the Golgari Rofarb actually pulled weight there, right? Just being the extra mana source was actually pretty good. I will say. I was very critical about it, but it did definitely help just having a third mana source with only two lands, for sure. That sucks. Oh, we're gonna take the card that snowballs out of control, so. And then we can push the Voidwalker if they don't take it. Both had the same thoughts. They just top decked it, which is actually good for me, because then we just played our hand and I should have played the fetch first, actually, because that way we can get lands in our graveyard through their Voidwalker. And just in case they have a scam effect, I should just push now. Then they're gonna thought seize me. They're gonna be very sad. Nice. Oh, we just have a saga. Nice. In that case, I'll just get in the 3-point damage. Reclaim is about to be a 3-4 next turn. Thoughtseize me. Nice. So GFTT is pretty clutch here. I'm assuming they're scam, not just regular Rakdos. I guess we can't assume that. But I just feel like that's what's tier one. So I think we cut the Witherbloom commands, add the extra Solgaleo Lantern for the scam effects. I could also see like Bitter Blossom coming in. But we'll just board like this. Board like this. Okay, so if they scam us, oh sure, that's fine. That's perfect. Our deck just wants us to play around Blood Moon. That's what it wants. Just play around Blood Moon. So next turn, if they don't do anything, I might just go Reclaimer. Oh, that. Yeah. Whatever. Sure. Hearse is nothing to me. So I'll double spell, go Thoughtseize, play around Blood Moon. I think I take the 2-for-1 Colgan's command. I can also take the Seasoned Pyromancer. Because that's like the redraw. Kind of want to take the Colgan's command. Like, if they rebuy Ragavan, that's just so bad for us. They Spiral, that's bad, but just like that. So far, like, with Colgan's command, it looks like it's just, like, regular Rakdos midrange. It might not just be, Okay, so they drew the third land. Don't think they had Blood Moon. Kind of want them to Spyro. Discard the Terminate. I guess they don't have to discard the Terminate, they discard the other two cards. That's annoying. I'll do this. So I don't want them to, like, get any advantage here. And then now, next turn, they can't really Spyro. I'm gonna sandbag this ball one turn. If they go Spyro. The Spyro is really awkward for them right here. Because, like, they kind of have to discard the Terminate, which is really good for us. Because that's their actual removal for this Bob. So if we can bait him to do that. That's what they're gonna do. 3. So they're going to discard this Terminate, which is really good for us. They may crew, which would also be very good for us. Yes. Kill that. So we got there the last two cards, and the card off the top isn't a removal spell. Springleaf Drum. Okay. We position ourselves to where we can try to untap with this Bob. If we don't untap with this Bob, we definitely need a knock on top of the deck for sure. But we're not in that bad of a spot, so we can untap with this. Obscure Confidante, yes. Yes. No. Yeah, I don't think we're going to win this game now. Or maybe we will. Maybe we will. So they are scam. That looks like I reckon in case they have croaks. I was hoping that would be able to just ambush their Spyro, but that did not happen. I'll save this one's up teeth for a Tyler Shocker. We have one. They scare a second endurance? They are not. Bolt my endurance. Did not play around the feigned death. We just wow. We were not destined to win that game. That game was just like not ours, apparently. But opponent was just like, nope, not happening. Opponent was like, nope. You are just gonna draw four lands in a row. And I have accepted my fate. So, basic Swamp into Thoughtseize into potentially Saga plus Bob. We could also play the Overrun Tomb in case we draw Tarmogoyf and then we get our shit discarded. Since we're on the play, I think I will go Overrun Tomb, Thoughtseize. That way we have a duel. If they grief us through a Thoughtseize and we draw Tarmogoyf, we can slam a Goyf. So, if we go basic Swamp, but just there's no real payoff there. So. And then that way, later, we can also just save the fetch. We do go to 16, but that is the Thoughtseize life. Okay. So their whole entire plan was getting this grief on one. We have the Thoughtseize for, or the Fatal Push for the monkey, so as long as we can dodge them drawing another Feign Death effect, we're in a decent spot. Oh, or we just draw Tarmogoyf. And I just stonewalls them. So I'll play Swamp here, play Tarmogoyf, and the next turn play Saga, Swamp, Dark Confidant, and then leave another black source for Fatal Push. That was actually a really good draw. They have to draw land plus terminate for that to happen. Oh my god. Okay, we got lucky there. Yeah, I'll play Saga. They could grief me here. They draw a land. God, I can't believe they had land plus terminate as our last cards. It's brutal. Brutal. The classic 2/1 stare down. Yeah, they should just make Bob a 1-mana spell, right? That just makes sense with the recent power creep. Might as well, fuck it, yeah. So I'll probably sandbag this Reclaimer because it just dies, this Hidetsugu consumes all. Although it does get taken by the grief, but I like either way they have answers to it, so it just depends on what we draw here. They're tanking though. Pass that flash though. So you can flash it at end of turn and you can untap with it. Oh, we get to untap with this Bob. Excellent. Removal spell. Discard spell. Since they have the grief and the Hidetsugu consumes all. I think I'm just gonna play out my hand. So the way they don't really gain any advantage here. They could try to grief if they draw a fourth land, but they pitch to grief. Sounds good. Do they have a undying spell? I have a forest opponent. Do they have an Undying spell? They do. So this Reclaimer can attack as a 3. Let's see what we draw here off this Bob. Oh, we just have a Detsu consumes all. Or Inquisition to take their Detsu consumes all. So we'll make a construct. Aldareth, I don't know why my stream decker is not working. Let me get the link for you. There you go. Oh, there you go. Oh, there was a space. I see. Guess I just get Shadow Spear. I could also just get, like, Spell Bomb. I also get Soul Guy Lantern too. I'll get the Spell Bomb. Let's take their Detsugu Kumzum's all. We don't care about Blood Moon. 8-11. Cool, cool, cool. Thoughtseize into Tarmogoyf with Bloodchief's Thirst is pretty good. Oh man, is this scam again? It's not. Is it burn? Yes. It is burn. Tarmogoyf. No Eidolon. Monogoyfs. Well, we'll plan to just not cast a spell the rest of the game. We will try to take over the game with these solid constructs. This is where, like, I feel like every matchup so far has been so bad to have the 4-2 Thoughtseize split, which is funny. Helix. So we have to hope that they don't have a skull crack here. There's a lot of burn online, that's for sure. I'm glad I added the Collective Brutality. It's only a one of, though, but it's better than nothing, I guess. Makes me want to go back down to a 3-3 Inquisition Thoughtsy split, though. With a lot of prowess and burn, and etc. I think I'm just going to get Shadow Spear and equip Tarmogoyf and attack. I think I attack with both. Two turn clock. Perhaps. They trade, wow. That's kind of wild to me. So do I Inquisition here, or do I play Tarmogoyf? I feel like Inquisition's the better play. Oh, but then I'll have lethal. I think Inquisition's better than Tarmogoyf here. Yeah, I think Inquisition is better than Tarmogoyf here. Because this peat land is kind of fucking him, right? Alright, so I think we take one of their one mana spells. So I guess I take the spear. Or the bolt. If they go Swiss Spear, bolt me, can't do anything. So I think we take the bolt. They go land. If we take the bolt, they can go land, Swiss Spear, spike. So that's 3, 4, 5. Yeah, we could also take the Swiss Man, that's guaranteed. But then, like, the thing is, like, once we gain the life here, like, we just win. So it doesn't really matter. I don't think it technically matters which one I take. I think Bolt's technically safer if they draw like Soulscarred Mage. I think I like taking the Bolt, it just feels safer. And then if they hold up if they draw Skullcrack again, it's still lethal. So still lethal. By the way, how's it going, board? Hope you do well, buddy. Always appreciate you dropping by. It's doing good. Just work's been busy, but work being busy is good. Apparently, I have to go across the country in April to do a talk for one of the projects I worked on, which is nerve-wracking. Very nerve-wracking, but should be a good experience. That's extra lethal. All right, here's where the brutality comes in clutch. The go for the throats. Two explosives. Let's go to Tarak, huh? So it's seven. So I think we board out the four thought seizes, the four bobs. And I guess we can board in either a force of vigor to tag like their Eidolons and their vortexes. I don't hate that. Maybe just like one. I think lantern's kind of loose. I think just having force of vigor is just another out to Eidolon. Seems good to me. It also makes like these withering commands a little bit better, I think. But Tarak is just being a generic 2-mana 2/1, try to block, or trade is good. Hand's a little sus, but I think we'll keep it. This Withering Fan doesn't really do anything. I may just take this hit from Swiss Spear if they just attack and don't do anything. Because I kind of want to push an Eidolon. Which is kind of what it looks like they look at. Oh, they did not attack. Interesting. Interesting line opponent. Well, I will push it anyway. To make them feel better about missing their attack. That will do them a courtesy fatal push to make them feel less stupid here. Is there a world where I can track them? I don't think so. I think I'm just gonna play Saga. Let's try to be proactive here. I feel like if we just pass, it just doesn't accomplish much. You got it, buddy. There's an argument to just play Windswept Teeth, but just so it makes, like, if we need to, like, cast a Fatal Push or Withering Command, like, if they go, like, Vortex, it makes it a little bit better, but hey, Mr. Boningles, hope you're well, buddy. Hope you're doing well. Alright, yeah, we're gonna make a Construct. I think they went to Shatter Effects. What is in their hand? I kind of want to like not fetch anything or make any construct because I feel like they just have a bunch of shatter effects or smash the smithing effects. Hi, Deathfrost. Hope you're doing well, buddy. I am doing good. Hey, John. Damn, everyone just popping in chat now at once. Everyone's popping in. I think I just, like, don't get Shadow Spear here. Is that greedy? No, let's just do it. I wish I had a drum in the deck. I wish it was in my hand. This is obviously they have smash effects. It's just like, do we want to rock into it? I don't think so. I think I should get Haywire Might, to be honest. Let's just gain some life. Let's just do that. Oh, yeah. Yeah, they're gonna smash my construct, sure. Alright. I have a feeling they just have a bunch of smash effects. Two, four, five. It's land for turn. So they have five live spells. Goblin Guide. I'll trade my construct with the Goblin Guide. Give me a land, please. Man. this is not good. Two, four, five. Eight. Back up to 10. I think I take this hit, actually. Do I mill here? Try to get land. Kind of want to just drain two. Hold up, push. Take it to 12. Take five, go to seven. And then we have lethal here. Let's do it. Train. I guess I could have just attacked first, but I should have attacked first. So we didn't go to 9, so if they have triple bolt, we're dead, but oh, they have the blaze. Oh, they have the smash. Okay, so we died a double bolt here. We could just die here. We accept our fate. Finally drew a land, but it does not seem to matter. So double smash, so it kind of made me feel like, what if we just like never played the saga, never tutor anything, and just like made their smashes dead? I don't know. It's It's an interesting thought process, a thought experiment. Maybe I want Lantern over Spell Bomb. That way we don't have to exile the graveyard to grow to cantrip and not shrink Tarmogoyf to cantrip. Sorry, that's what I meant to say. This is kind of an interesting hand, but I guess we'll try it. I'm hoping they just go Roiling Vortex. Roiling Vortex costs 2? Yeah, hopefully they cast that card. Depending on what they do here and what we draw next turn, I may just have to get a rot farm if I don't draw lands. Bolt is good for us. Man, triple Witherbloom Command is not seeing good here. I need them to play a Roiling Vortex. Like right here, and then... another one drop. Yes! Yes! Yes. Oh, so good. I think it's okay if they want to eat a Boros Charm. Let's just do it now. Five cards is scary. So they had the charm, so I'm glad I cracked the E to play around that. Position. Don't want to get my spear smashed. I should draw this Inquisition last turn. Inquisition them, but like exposes whatever we have. Kind of just want to get Soul Guy Lantern or a Streamleak Drum, sorry, and save my Shadow Spear. I'll attack. Path to Exile. Lava Spike. I think I take the Skull Crack here. And then we can just try to wither them, command them out. Them not having any smashes is good for us. Three, six, four, eight, six. Is it worth it to deal that extra point of damage? They're probably palm my construct. So we can take a four, go to 10, virtual seven, back up to nine. They have spike plus path. Let's go to 8. Just debating if I want to play this bauble. Is an extra point of power detrimental to me? So I go 10 to 7. 4. Buy my up to 6. Yeah, so the extra power actually is detrimental to me. 9. 7. Yeah. So we'll attack with just these constructs. We'll see if they palm. They might. Hi, friend of the crypt. Hope we're doing well, buddy. So I'm gonna actually sandbag this point of power because going like to 10 is actually detrimental. Like, I'd rather just go to 11. So, target opponent loses, drain. So, target. So, they go to 6. I could just go Urborg and Wither and Command them again. They go to 4. Yeah, I don't think we have a lack of threats here. Just gonna drain him. And then this gets him out of bolt range. This just feels safe to me. Now we're at 15. We're to 12. Our constructs are out of bolt range. They have one path for one construct, but not the other. It just feels safer to be at... I guess it doesn't matter if we have 12 versus 11. It just feels safer. Oh. Sure. So the 1 point actually cost me here. Actually, it doesn't matter. There's a path. So. I think it's safe to crack here. Swiss beer. So that's probably game. Just gonna drain him again. Just Witherbloom Command their ass. There's 3 Witherbloom Commands. So they have Spike plus Swift Spear. Cool. Just 3 Witherbloom Commands. Just 3. All 3 of them. Just at their face. At their face. Kind of a loose hand, but we'll keep it. So we lost to Merfolk, beat Prowess, beat Scam, beat Burn. That was a sequence of events. Looks like it's sack. Rakdos sacrifice. Kind of awkward that we're playing a naked Tarmogoyf out here, but what do you do? I think that last match was a perfect example of our burn opponent over sideboarding. They board in Deflecting Palm, Path to Exile, like all those cards just like do not matter. Golly. Where's our fetch land? We're gonna have to take it. Really glad that they whiff. As we have 2 sorcery speed removal as well as by that damn ragged man. Is a blood moon? That would be awful. That's not a blood moon. Okay. That doesn't kill my Goyf. Worst Tarmogoyf ever. No wonder the Zoomers hate Tarmogoyf. Look how bad this Tarmogoyf is. Such an awful magic card. Did they miscount the Tarmogoyf math, though? I don't know why they just pinged it. Absolutely fantastic. Look how good this Tarmogoyf is! Look how good this Tarmogoyf is. Look how beautiful this Tarmogoyf is. Not the Bletchy's Thirst is Mayon Devil, I think. In which case, do I just get a Springleaf Drum? I think so. I wish one of these were Fatal Pushes. They could have just, like, made a Construct. Get Rufal, play the Winter Tap, or untapped, and push the Man Devil and have a Construct. It would have been so much better if these were Fatal Pushes. But alas, I think we just get the Drum. Let's get our mana online a little bit better. We do take one, unfortunately. This is a sacrifice effect. They ping me. Good call, good call, good call. And then this Goyf is about to be supersized here. Boom. Hi-ya! I draw another land, I can Tarmogoyf plus equip Shadow Spear. Oh, let's see how bad this Ragavan is. I guess they had the Ragavan, huh? That's my fault. So maybe I shouldn't have attacked with both. Yeah, I just decided to not defend the Ragavan. Okay. They decide to not dash Ragavan, which is good for us. Okay. Land would be really good because we can go land, make mana off tracker, it makes a clue, and then the construct grows. Interesting. They're being really aggressive with their village rights. I guess the Summergriff is pressuring them a lot. Well, we got our wish. I guess I could also just, like, make a Tarmogoyf, too. Tyrus Tracker going these constructs is pretty good. Yeah, I have a one of. I really like it as a one of in this list. It feels really good. Cases like this where it's just like, I think having three endurance, one tracker has felt really good I want to defend against a dash Ragavan. This is a lot of pressure. I'd rather commit more to the board. Like, could we have dealt 4 more damage? Sure, but, like, I think just getting this tracker down, or getting this Tarmogoyf down, and then just, like, this turn, equip a Shadow Spear onto something, and then attack for Luthor here, with the backup Bloodchief's Thirst, is, in my opinion, a little bit better. I could be wrong. Like, your line definitely is the more aggressive line. I'm kind of thinking maybe an extra turn ahead, just to, maximize my pressure and make sure like my opponent just can't deal with my whole board, right? Because this is a lot of pressure. Arguably too much pressure. If they Fury, that's fine. But that's more reason for me to commit another 5-6 to the sideboard, right? Or in the sideboard, to the battlefield. So I'm trying to look up this list. Like, Fury is more of an argument to commit more to the board. Like, if they want to kill my tracker, sure, that's fine. That's fair. But trying to find the deck, but as our opponent's just like, oops, my bad. Okay. I think I'll crack a clue here. Just to like grow this by one. And then if we hit a land, it just like the construct just I'm not playing this Bob, I don't think. I'm kinda high rolling a land here. In theory. I could have maybe thirst this and then equip, but I think this is just not free, but out. So now we can equip Shadow Spear. Let's equip another Tarmogoyf. I think this tracker was played its dues. I think at that point I just attack with everything. Go for the Thoke Kills, Mayhem Devil. That's kind of the number one card that fucks us over. So I'm gonna board in those. Fury Grief. So they have like some rebirth effects. I don't know if it's worth the board in, like, the other Lantern. I'm going to be completely honest. I haven't played against this deck in Modern. I played it in Pioneer, so I'm like, in Pioneer, they have all those threatened effects. I don't know if that's the case here. So it's trying to find, how's it going, Wally One? Hope you know, buddy. So the main win condition, it seems like it's Goblin Bombardment, which is pretty big. Which makes Wyndham Command pretty good here. They could Grief or Furious. I think we keep in all the discard spells. I think we keep in all the Fatal Pushes and such. To be honest, I kind of just want to board out, like, X number of Dark Confidant. Maybe at least one. It's not Pioneer legal. I know, I feel like my audience is split now between Pioneer and Modern. I'm personally enjoying Modern a lot more than Pioneer. But I feel like most of my fam, like my audience, prefers Pioneer in my opinion. But maybe that's wrong. I think we brought out one Thoughtseize. I could also bring in Pithing Needle. Pithing Needle named Golem Environment seems pretty good, right? Modern all the time. All the time. Modern all the time. I just feel like Pioneer is very redundant. It's mono white, mono green, Phoenix, Grease Fang, Control. There's not much like deviation other than that, which is unfortunate. But I still think the format's fine. I think I just need to pace myself playing that format. I think I definitely burned myself out of it, trying to like prep for my RCQ that I ended up not even playing in, which is kind of funny. So the Mulligan is 6. Waiting to cast a spell. Do they play Blood Moon? They play Magus of the Moon. What the fuck? What kind of hand are you keeping an opponent? I guess they roll into 6. Yikes. They draw something. I'm gonna play around Blood Moon. This doesn't play around Fury, but I don't think I can really play around Fury right now. They attack, I taking. Easy. GFTT is a good draw. I'm gonna hold up Endurance. They hit a Terminate. That's not good. That sucks. Their hand is Grief, Sokinzen. They could play this Den, which is going to be a problem later. They Grief me here. Okay, that's fine. So the hand is Sokinzen, Unknown. I'm going to let this resolve because I have 2 Endurances, so it doesn't really matter. I will end step this Endurance, that is for sure. And then it's a matter of, do I want, if they take this Tarmogoyf, If I wanted to go for the throat, I could just try to do it next turn, right? Like, if they take this go for the throat, that's actually fine. I actually wouldn't mind them taking this go for the throat, because, like, I don't really care about this 3-2, low-key. I want to commit this endurance to the battlefield, because we will win this race. Especially because they need to play this den. So I'm not... I guess I could hit them if they play Kroxa. Yeah, so I should do it, because like we already have land creature, sorcery, and graveyard, so it's actually better to do this. So here I could like thirst this if I really wanted to. I'm tempted just like endurance again. I could also just play Tarmogoyf and just raise. I may just play Tarmogoyf and just raise. Yeah, I'm gonna play this Tarmogoyf and raise. I think we're in a racing situation. I'm not gonna bother blocking this. A middling saga deck. I mean, you could say that. I guess I don't hate you for thinking that, that's for sure. I wish I played around this Magus, I guess. But this Goyf is a 5-6, though. So, like, if they don't attack at this Grief, I'm just going to attack with this Goyf and then pass. They play the Silken Zen. So, oops. Yeah, I don't know why they played the Silken Zen. Did they run two? Yeah, I don't know. Low-key, I have no idea. I think we just take out everything. I don't think they're going to block with the... Oh, I should play this Rot Farm first. Mistakes were made. Mistakes were made. But I don't think they're going to double block here. I don't think they're going to double. I don't think they're gonna. Okay. That does shrink our Goyf in next turn, which does kind of suck. Okay, that sucks too. Because. We can get in for enchantment, sorcery. Can I get in for three? We get in for creature, instant land. So we get in for... Yeah. Oh, we can't thirst. I need double block to kick this Wolverine MTG. That's a good draw. One sec. They exiled the wrong guards. So they need an answer to this reclaimer, or we can get a basic swamp, thirst this Magus, and win the game from there. Tarmogoyf is a puny zero, little 0/1. They top decked Fury? Are you fucking kidding me? Oh my god, that's so... Oh. What the fuck? What the hell? Okay. Sure. Oh, we can, endurance now, too. Oh my god. Unbelievable. Opponent just wanted to punt the game. El Punterino. They do not respect this reclaimer at all. At all. Please attack. Please attack. Oh, I guess this has we could trade endurance with this Fury. But then, if they have, like, a rebirth effect, then we lose. I think we have to block here. I think we have to keep our life total a little bit higher. Dude, our opponent needs to stop ripping like this. Oh my god. That's just insane. So, how do we get out of this? Well, we got basic swamp to play around. They also fucked up. Destroy that. They have to block. We are slowly chipping away. We are crawling back. Perfect. Perfect. Don't rip. Don't rip. They did not rip. So they can make the hearse into a 5/6. I think we just play the long game, make some constructs. So they can shrink Goyf to a sorcery land, so it's creature instant. So they can shrink Goyf into a 2/3 with this hearse, which is kind of annoying, but. Oh, absolutely, Mord. Absolutely. So I'm gonna do this and play a long game. Fun boys, thank you for the follow. Appreciate it. I'm gonna play a long game, get some sagas. Finally bought my Christmas gifts? What do you mean? It's, I guess, I don't know. I guess December 8th isn't technically too late, that's for sure. Wow, they can make a 5/5. Endurance. I did it December 10th, 20th last year. Yeah, I was gonna say, like, 20th is about, like, I think the average. You know? Oh, Haywiremite? Yeah. Haywiremite would be a great target here. If they. So they are one damage short from sacrificing this. It might be good. Oh my god, get out of here. Get out of here. I am ashamed and appalled. I could also just get pithing the old name Hearst, so I don't have to spend a mana. Excuse me. Make a construct. Might make Scoif bigger. But it makes a construct smaller. Right? And might does an extra damage with the Mayhem Devil. So. Darn. I wonder if this is in paper, if they would remember that trigger. Makes me wonder. Makes me wonder. The art on this card's so cool, the back end of it. I really like the art on this card. Maybe not the front half, but definitely the vessel of all consuming is I definitely like the art on that one. It's really cool. And the funny thing about this card is I didn't realize the face of Mayhem Devil is like right here. I don't know if you can see my cursor on the stream. But like, I always thought like the face was like here. I thought the devil was facing like the top right. I didn't realize that, like, I never seen the card in person, and I always saw it, like, not even in this window. I always just looked at it here. So if you even look at it here with the swirls cover the face of the Mayhem Devil. So I always thought, like, do you see that little, like, yellow thing here? I thought that was the eye. Like, I thought that was the head here. So, like, this is the head. So, like, I thought this was the head, and that was the arm. On that note. 4-1. So we lost our Merfolk. We beat Prowess. We beat Rakdos Scam. We beat Rakdos Sack. And then we beat Burn. We're constantly 4-1-ing with this deck. And that feels good. It's one of those things where, like, you can consistently trophy. Like, would you rather, like, 5-0 and 0-5 or, like, go 4-1 consistently? And I'd rather go 4-1 consistently because, like, your win percentage is 80% versus a 50% winner, right? So, again, this deck has felt great. I think the one of Tracker is really, really good. Definitely pull weight there. Triple Witherbloom Command win the game against Burn. Haywire Might had value, of course. GFTT has always been great. We did play against Burn. We did not draw the Collective Brutality, but I think this is a good hedge against the meta where I was like, I feel like I'm naked against Burn. I want something against Burn, and we have Brutality. Brutality might not be the right call because... Prowess is getting more popular, so maybe the brutality would be something else. Crazy 19681, thank you for the follow, appreciate it. So like maybe the brutality should be something else. And did I miss a follow, Fun Boys? If I missed your follow, thank you so much, I really appreciate it. So whatever this slot is, this slot should be dedicated towards Burn. Whether it's a brutality, whether it's a Weather the Storm, something of that nature should be this slot. I did have a Bojuka Bog before, and I think just having something that's more dedicated towards Burn, where I haven't really played against Living End much, and even then, we have, like, Lantern, we have two Necromancers, we have the main next problem, like, I think, and we have the 3-minute Endurances, right? So it's like, I think I'd rather hedge towards Burn, where we're a little bit more naked with the 4 Bobs and the 4 Thoughtseizes, than, you know, hedge more against Living End, where we already have a bunch of hate towards it. I do think that maybe if the meta is going towards Burn and Prowess, I think we do have to go back to a 3-3 Inquisition Thoughtseize split. So I think that is what I'll probably change the next time I stream. But again, 4-1 is something that's great. We're doing really well with this deck consistently. So I'm really happy with where we are with the deck. Let me look up Avengers Zendikar. You didn't know it had a face. Because it's right here, right? But then again, I have this card in real life, so it's like... Yeah, it's right here. This is his face, right? Unless I'm wrong. Watch, I'm like completely wrong. I'm like, yeah, this is the face, right? And like the head's like over here. That'd be hilarious. But like, from my understanding, I think the face is right here. Correct me if I'm wrong. But I really appreciate you for tuning in and hanging out. I don't think I'll be able to stream Friday. I might be able to. I'm not entirely sure. I think I'm going to take this weekend off. So I might... The earliest I'll probably be back is maybe Monday, if not tomorrow. So I really appreciate you tuning it out. Well, that's the face that I really never noticed, though. Yeah, it's one of those things where, like, when you're zoomed out so much, it's hard to tell, right? Another thing is, like... I think this is a common one. It's, like, Signal Pest. I think this is a really, really common one where people, like, think this is the head... Like, people think this is the head, but the head's right here. And I didn't know that for, like, the longest time. I always thought this was the head facing the horizon. But it's these are the two hands, and this is the head. I think this is a really, really common one. But again, I really appreciate tuning in out. If you want to check my past streams, go to my YouTube. If you want to join the Discord, come hang out, talk more about Rock and Pioneer and Modern, please do so. Follow me on Twitter, subscribe to my YouTube. Chicken Pest, exactly. Let's raid Evan, shall we? Again, I think I'll try to be back tomorrow. If not, I'll be back Monday for sure. So again, hit those follow buttons on Twitter. It's free. Follow on Twitter. Follow on Twitch. Sub on YouTube. Join the Discord. I really appreciate you hanging out. Let's send Evan some love, shall we? Let's turn off this. All right, everyone. Take care. Stay safe. Stay healthy. Bye.